Hi, I'm Megan Atufle and I make interactive floors. And today I'm going to show you how I made this really cool interactive floor experience with space whales. I hope you like it. I know Momo loves it. It just reveals cool whales, wipes away the frost from the basement window of your spaceship. There's also audio space whale sounds. I'm going to show you exactly how I made this, how you can make it. All of the equipment that you need will be linked in the description. And if you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments or you can contact me at info@lumoplay.com. Let's get started. The software that I'm using to make my interactive floor effect today is LUMOplay. This is the software that my friends and I make, and it's been available in one form or another since 2010, 2011. And we made it originally for teachers. So it's very easy. It's made for people who are not necessarily coders, but who are very creative. And as long as you know how to hook a projector and a computer and a camera together and hang them up somewhere, you're going to be able to make an interactive floor or wall experience with our software. The software also comes with over 350 apps and games that we've made, and obviously we're always adding new ones, so there's tons of stuff to try. If you decide that you want to try this out yourself, you can go to lumoplay.com and download LUMOplay free. It doesn't cost anything to try this, so if you are looking at potentially putting an interactive floor into your business or your home or your school or your event, definitely try LUMOplay before you make a decision, because it's so easy to use and it's so much fun and there's so much that you can do with it. The software version that I'm using for making my apps and games today is called LUMOplay Maker, and Playmaker allows me to publish as many custom apps as I want to, so it's really, really good for agencies. If you're not planning on making a lot of custom stuff, then we have an at-cost license called Lumo Playground. So you can check out our prices on our website, and if you have any questions, let me know. The templates that I use to make custom apps and games are built right into LUMOplay in the Motion Maker section. So we're going to open that up, and the template that I'm using today is called Frost Reveal. So it's this one right here. I'm going to click Create, and that will open up the template on my computer, and there's two parts to that. There's the controls and there's the actual app. So you can test your app as you're building it. I made my cursor really big just so that it shows up okay on video, but obviously if you have a touchscreen or if you have your design computer hooked up to your final installation, then you can play with this using your camera or using your touchscreen. I'm going to start by naming my app. I'm going to call it Space Whale. And then I'm going to remove this frame overlay because I don't need the window frame. So this is in the overlays section, and this is where you would put things like graphics that aren't interactive, that don't disappear, and a call to action that you want appearing only when nobody's playing with the interactive floor or wall. I'm not going to be using the overlays, I rarely do, but they're here for branding and logos and stuff if you need to use them. And also you can create different kinds of masks. So in this case, the mask is the window frame, but if you wanted to make a projection that is a circle instead of a rectangle, you can put a mask image that's all black with just a transparent circle in the middle, and that'll give you an irregular shape instead of the full projection. So I'm going to close the overlays and move on to the background, and I'm going to replace the background video. Oh, I forgot to get rid of the frame. Just get rid of that. Go on to the background and replace that video with the video that I made of my space whales. I put sound in this video, whale sounds, because I think it makes the effect cooler. But I'm gonna mute them for now, just so that you're not having to listen to creepy whale sounds while I'm explaining this. But as you can see, we're almost done. All I need to do now is change the snow, affect the snow, and change the way that the frost behaves. So I'm gonna close the background video. Just a quick note about making videos for these types of effects. The article for this template is linked in the description, and it has the compression you should use and the sizes we recommend. But basically, we're using Unity for the back end of our game production, and it does not do video well. So it's better to have a longer loop, but to compress it. And it's also really important that you build your background video for this effect for the resolution of your installation display. So this video is 1920 by 1080. My floor projection is 16 by 9 and it's 1080p. And so if you don't know how any of that works, you need some advice, you can contact me, but it's also listed in the article that's linked in the description of this video. I'm going to go into the snow. I'm going to turn the snow down so that it's as small as I can make it. I'm not going to have quite as much. And I'm going to make sure there's almost no wind, and I'm also going to reduce the gravity. So it just isn't really moving that much. I think if you go to one side, the wind will blow in one direction, and if you go to the other side, the wind blows the snow in the other direction. Maybe I'll make it a little bit bigger so you can see better. So you can actually create snow that is... This is a little slow. There we go. Now we have some big flakes. It'll be easier to see. So I can change the direction of the wind, and if you put it right in the middle, then it doesn't really move that much at all. It'll just kind of float around. So again, I'm going to turn it back down to the smallest size I can make it. And the reason there's like a little bit of a delay in size is because those big particles are still on the screen. So they have to, I have to wait for them to clear out. A good way to clear them out early is just turn the wind up. And then you can kind of see they're shrinking now. And all these big particles will eventually disappear. And that's basically what I want, is I just want a couple like light dots that are moving in the background. So it doesn't really look so much like snow as it does just a random particle effect. I'm gonna close this and open the frost. And there's only one setting for the frost, and it's called the growth time. And that's basically how fast the frost returns. So if I make the growth time really short, then it's the frost is going to come back right away. And if I make the growth time really long, then the part that I reveal is going to stay revealed for a really long time. So I'm going to set that back to kind of the default and maybe make it just a little bit longer. And that's it. I've made my space whales effect, so I'm going to click save, and it'll save the effect with the thumbnail that it captures, and that'll make it easier for me to find my effect when I'm ready to use it. And I just need to click publish. When I click publish, it's going to give me a little warning saying that I can't edit the effect once it's been published. So that's really important to know if you are making something. Definitely test it, make sure that you're completely happy with it before you publish it. If you're using Lumo Playground, there will be an additional step asking you to pay for your app. But with Playmaker, I can publish as many custom Motion Maker apps as I want to. So I'm just going to click OK, and then it'll upload my app, and I'll be able to access it from every installation in my account. I hope you liked this week's tutorial. I had a lot of fun making this effect. I definitely want to explore interactive whales at some point. So if you are an active LUMOplay subscriber, please consider leaving us a request. We take requests and add apps to our library for free for all of our subscribers. So if you're already using LUMOplay and you have an idea for an app or a game, whether it's space whales or anything else, you can leave it in our community request forum, And if you have any questions about this video or how you can make an interactive floral wall or what kind of equipment you need, you can leave a comment on the video or you can contact me at info@lumoplay.com. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. The exposure that we get from these YouTube videos is kind of what sustains our company. So any engagement or, you know, hitting like, subscribing, that really, really helps our company a lot. It helps us keep the price of this type of software as low as possible for everyone. I'll see you next week with another tutorial.